almost 10 years ago. I had started working on a country record. So this was something that I knew I was gonna do for a long time. In my mind, I always thought if I was gonna make a country record, the proper thing to do is to go to Nashville. However, I wasn't just gonna pick up and move. And I realized I need to make the record here. The name of the record is Calico. It is a truncated word for California country. And I've been extremely inspired by the energy of California. When I say there ain't no rules and anything goes, in Calico, I'm referring to this very free atmosphere to create in, where it's like, okay, you want to make a country record here, what does that sound like, and what does that look like? This literally is the Wild West, so it's just bringing all of those elements together to find this kind of California country. For me, in the past, I would start on the piano or the guitar, which we did. We didn't play any piano, so that's one giant difference. No piano on this record. We would start with a beat. We'd bring out the guitars. It was like all happening simultaneously. Like by the end of the day, there was a demo. I never saw myself as an American Idol contestant. I referenced this in the song Calico. You know, the second verse is, I never planned to be on television, but I got a golden ticket out to Hollywood. Every week, good people made the time to listen. I felt like they believed in me more than I ever could. And that's just so true. Like, I didn't believe I was American Idol worthy. I wasn't planning on it. I got there, I got the ticket, and really people did believe in me. And they just kept voting, and I made it as far as I did. And I always say that American Idol was like boot camp for rock stars. So let's pretend like the music business is Mount Everest, and American Idol takes you to the top of that mountain. You're up there for a little bit, you see that it exists, and when it's over, they drop you back down at base camp with a backpack and spiky shoes, and now it's your turn to climb back up that mountain. We understood what an incredible opportunity it was to have that kind of exposure, to have that, especially then, it was like 40 million viewership. I mean, the only thing that I wish we had back then was social media, like we do now. You know, we didn't accumulate like these big followings while we were on the show. We didn't have Instagram or Twitter. I mean, what you're getting out of this is the experience and this fan base that you take along with you, and then you just honor them and you keep giving them music. I think one thing that we realized on American Idol, and it happened for years, is that girls weren't winning. And when you think about the voting audience, I don't have the demo, you know, stats right in front of me, but the mass majority of voters are girls, are females. In terms of like getting support for your music, it's like, do women support women? There are those out there who break through, like Taylor Swift, who girls like, girl, you know, she's one of those girls that girls like. If you're not like a Harry Styles or like a One Direction, where it's like there's this appeal of being a guy and attracting that female audience that just is crazy about them and follows them around. And I don't think women have that type of thing. And so I think there has been a pressure for women to appeal to the male base by using, again, their body and their sexuality. I see that happening less now, which I think is great. The best thing you can do is just go out with great songs and really connect with your people and stay strong in your message, you know, and not deviate and feel the pressure to go a different way. I have a lot of passion for being a mother. I have a lot of passion for making music, and neither of them really feel like side projects, right? Do I think that balance is achievable? I think there's areas of balance that are achievable. Or phases, but there's some times where it's just really off kilter in both directions. And I just think that's life. Like, I'm trying to beat myself up less about that, particularly when it comes to my kids. I just don't ever want them to suffer because of mommy's big dreams. But also, I want them to value my dreams. I want them to value that dreams are important, that not, they're important to me, and their dreams are important to me. And that they see that as a woman and as a mother, that I am, you know, I am doing both things. And so I feel really thankful to have my family and my children and my husband who are just troopers. I remember thinking I wanted a major record deal really bad. And then I was on American Idol and I got off the show and I was very close to that. Like, I thought that was gonna happen. Like, I was so close. And then things took a quick turn and I made the decision to do them independently. What I got as an independent was to be more free, but have less support financially and with the team. So it's like over time, I've just realized that nothing's perfect. Don't ever think you're going to get to this certain place and then you're set. It's a journey. There's no perfect thing. Enjoy it now.